In this video, we derive the steady flow energy equations by using this open system. So here you see this is the animations of the open system. Okay, it is the control surface we consider. This is the section 1, means it is the inlet section. Here the fluid is in. Okay, and these are the various inlet parameters U1, P1, V1, C1 and H1. Here it is the outlet section. Here it is, name is given section 2. Okay, so here the fluid is out, and here the outlet parameter is mentioned U2, P2, V2, C2 and H2. This is the datum line. From the datum line, we measure the Z1 and Z2. So here you see this is a Z1 and this is a Z2. So first we understand these parameters in the details, then after we derive these equations. Consider a flow of fluid through a generalized open system as shown in the figure. Okay, open system means that is a mass interaction is there, mass in, mass out. Energy interaction means heat transfer and the work transfer is takes place, it is called as the open system. So this is our system or a control volume. In short, control volume is written as the CV. Okay, so this square, we draw it is the control surface, means on this portion we focus our study. This is the section 1. Okay, and this section 1 have a area A1, fluid in, this fluid have a various parameters U1, P1, V1, C1 and H1. Same way at the outlet that we already mentioned, so we move towards the next topics. Okay. So next point, the working fluid enter the system at section 1 and leave the system at the section 2, passing at the steady rate. Why it is passing at the steady rate? Because the theory name is the steady flow energy equation, means flow at the steady rate. Flow means that is a, already I discussed about the what is a steady flow and unsteady flow. Okay, so I upload this video today before. If you don't know what is a steady and unsteady flow, then I provide the link on the card. Card means on a top right screen of your mobiles or a laptop, you see the I symbols. Now first term is use M. M means that is a mass flowing through the control volume, and the unit of mass is kg per second. Next parameter is the capital Q, heat entering the control volume, and unit of the heat is kilojoule. Okay, but in this image we are not indicating any Q and work interactions. Okay, so in every open system it is not necessary the heat and work interaction is there. Okay, suppose we are considered a nozzle, so in a nozzle heat and work interaction is not there, then we consider Q and W is zero. Okay, so I upload for that all the applications video later on. W means work transfer and its unit is the kilojoule. C1 and C2, here you see we mentioned C1 and C2. So all the one parameter, means here one is written in a subscript, it indicates the inlet. And for the outlet, we use the two parameters. So C1 and C2 is the velocity of the fluid at entrance and the exit. The C1 is indicated for the entrance, C2 is indicated for the exit in meter per seconds. Next one is P1 and P2, pressure of fluid at the entrance and exit, and the unit of the pressure is Newton per meter square. U1 and U2, internal energy per kg of fluid at entrance and exit, kilojoule per kg. Next one is the V1 and V2, that is the specific volume of the fluid at entrance and exit, meter cube per kg is the unit of specific volume. H1 and H2, it is the enthalpy of the fluid at entrance and exit, kilojoule per kg. CV, it is denoted as control volume. Now here small q word is used. Okay, so already we mentioned capital Q. Capital Q, that is the heat entering. Okay, small q is also the heat entering to the control volume, but here per kg of fluid is mentioned, so unit is changed, that is kilojoule per kg. Okay, so here for the what amount of the mass, for this particular mass is given. Okay, but when we divide this capital Q by the mass, then it gives the small q. Same way small w, that the work transfer is divided by the kg of the fluid supply, then it is converted to the small w, that is the work transfer from the control volume per kg of fluid, kilojoule per kg. Now we derive this equation for that. Okay, one parameter is missing, that is z1 and z2, that is the elevation of entrance section and the exit sections in a meter. Okay, so this is the one type of the height, it is measured in a meter. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to engineering thermodynamics and another subject of the mechanical engineering. For that, various playlists is provide. The energy balance required in open system for the flow process may be written as follow. So first we mentioned the energy balance. Energy balance means what we supplied and what we get. Okay, same way that what food we eat, that we measure in calorie, and what work we do, that is also converted in calorie. Okay, then we are balanced. Okay, our body is not growing. That means what we take the calorie from the food is equal to the what work we doing. So same way we apply the energy balance equations to the open systems. Okay, so first energy entering to the control volume plus heat entering to the control volume. Okay, so these are the generally two inputs, that is the energy entering to the control volume plus heat entering to the control volume. And what is the outlet? So in a outlet, that is the three parameters, that is the energy leaving to the control volume, same way here energy entered and energy must be leave. And suppose we supplied the heat, then it is converted into the work. And suppose we supplied the work, then we convert into the heat. Okay, depending on that, we consider here the minus and plus signs. Okay, but we consider the heat as an input. Same way on the output, we achieve some work done. So work transferred from the control volumes. And sometime the energy is stored, that is the increase of stored energy within the control volume. That's why in outlet, there is a three parameters is mentioned. Now, for a steady flow process, increase of stored energy within the control volume is zero. Means suppose steady flow process means that is a flow is continuously going on with the constant rates. All the parameters are constant with respect to the time. It is called steady flow process. Okay. So when the steady flow process, increase of stored energy means this last term in these above equations are considered as the zero. So only the fourth part is remaining in the inlet, that is the energy entering, heat entering, energy leaving, and the work transfer from the control volume. This parameter is zero for the steady flow process. Now, this energy entering to the control volume, so that energy in a different forms. Okay, so it is possible that the internal energy at section 1, flow work at the section 1, generally inlet at fault we use the section 1. Okay, that's why here section 1 is mentioned. It is also forming a kinetic energy and potential energy. Sometimes that is a 2 or 3 form of energy is available, no internal energy is available. So depending on that, we consider the parameter either some value or a zero. Okay. Second step is same, that is a heat entering to the control volume equal to for outlet energy leaving to the control volume. Same way, internal energy at section 2, flow work at the section 2, kinetic energy at section 2, potential energy at section 2. Means it is the same, only instead of section 1 we here written section 2, plus this parameter is as it is, that is the work transfer from the control volume. Now these things are changed in a form of the equations. Okay, so we need to, these all the parameters is depend on the mass. Okay, if mass is changed, then value of these all the parameters are changed. That's why here it is multiplied with the m. Okay, so m1 in bracket internal energy is denoted as the u1, flow work at the section 1 it is denoted as the p1 v1, kinetic energy at the section 1 it is c1 square by 2, potential energy at section 1 it is denoted as z1 into g. Okay, this parameter is over, so we complete this big bracket. Plus heat entering to the CV, it is denoted as the Q, that we already studied, is equal to, same way for the outlet, these all the parameters are depend on the mass. So here at the section 2 means it is denoted as the M2. Okay, in bracket internal energy U2, flow work at section 2 it is denoted as P2 V2, kinetic energy at section 2 is denoted as C2 square by 2, potential energy at section 2 is denoted as Z2 plus D, bracket over, plus work transfer from the control volume, it is denoted as W. So this is the equation number 1. Okay, so further simplification of this equation is available. Okay, from these equations we are deriving the different equations for the different application, means for the nozzles, for the turbine, for the pump. That is an equation derivation is possible from these equations. Okay, so I also prepared this all type of the video for all the application, that all the videos are available within the week. Okay, so equation 1 is the general energy equation. It is applicable to compressible and incompressible fluid, liquid and gas, idle and real fluids. Applying the steady state process condition as a mass of the working fluid entering to the control volume is equal to leaving from the control volume, means m1 is equal to m2 is equal to m. So we consider the steady flow means mass is flowing at constant rate. So m1 is entered, then M2 is leaving. Okay, so both are the same because it is the steady flow process. So it is M1 and M2 are replaced with the M for the further calculation. Okay, so I taking this same step again. Okay, so here from the next step, so we replace this M1 as a M and M2 as a M. Okay, so other parameters are same. We are not changing anything. Now this U1 plus P1V1 means internal energy plus flow work is denoted as the enthalpy. So here you see that U1 plus P1V1 is written as the H1. U2 plus P2V2 is replaced by the H2. Here by mistake the H1 is there, but it is H2. Okay. So here you see that the U1 plus P1V1 is replaced by H1. Another thing is same. Same way here U2 plus P2V2 is replaced by H2. Other parameters are same. So we consider this is the equation number 2. Equation 2 is called the steady flow energy equation, and this is also the first law of thermodynamics applied to open system for steady flow process. Steady flow energy equation for unit mass SFEE means it is a short form of steady flow energy equation. Now for unit mass means we need to divide this equation by the mass. It is called as the unit mass. Okay, so we divide these all the parameters by the mass. So here with this parameter M is already there. Okay, so this M is cancelled. So H1 plus C1 square plus Z1G. With this Q, M is not in multiplication, so we need to divide. So here the we divide the Q by mass. Same way here with all these three parameter M is there, so we divide by M, so M is cancelled. So H2 plus C2 square plus Z2G plus work done divided by M. Okay, that is a W by M. So we already study in the notifications that the Q by M is written as the small Q, and work done W by M is denoted as the small W. Okay, so these equations are changed. Other parameters are remains constants. So this is the final equations. But generally we use these equations. That is equation number 2 for the further application, means deriving for the further equations. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels, and don't forget to share with your friends.